You're watching Next Tech Insider, where we're looking to banter and debate on some of the hottest innovation issues with some really brilliant thought leaders in the industry. In my hot seat today is Victoria Peppiatt, co-founder and CEO of Phrasee. So you guys basically aim to write better marketing copy than humans.
That is it.
Fantastic. 100%. AI has captured mainstream attention. It feels like it's kind of more in the last 2 years, but actually it's nowhere near a new concept. It's been in play for decades. So why do you think public imagination is so taken by what artificial intelligence can do?
You're 100% right. It's been around for decades. And I think part of it now is the hype that films have brought, things like the Terminator and robots and AIs coming to get you and it's going to take over the world. And to be honest, it's quite a lot of scaremongering. It's not where we are.
So with, let's say, the whole jobs debate, I'm guessing that your point of view is that AI will augment our existing 100%. Work rather than displace it. Tell me more about that.
I mean, 100%. What's really interesting about this, I mean, I can only talk from my personal perspective, but, you know, we launched Phrasee 3.5 years ago, and I would say probably 60% of the jobs at that point didn't exist. You know, so it's not like we can go out and recruit language technicians. These are new roles that are being created by AI companies. And I think there's some really interesting reports and analysis out there. PwC have just released a report which is looking at jobs displacement over the next 20 years. In fact, it looks like it's pretty much equal. I think it's just a little bit more jobs will be generated. So I think it's 7 million they predict in the UK. 7 million jobs will be lost, but 7.2 will be created. And I think you've just got to think about how evolution has happened and through the decades what's happened, because we cannot stay static. We need to embrace it.
And so, Vic, when it comes to talent, because there are a lot of folks, let's say, watching this video who want to work in this space, but equally, I think we forget a little bit about folks that are, let's say, more mature employees who've been in a particular profession, whether it's professional services or retail, or FMCG, wherever they sit in that, could be an HR manager, you know, who are genuinely coming up to me and going, well, okay, so you're a futurist, so you do this stuff all the time. Now, you're saying that it's going to create as many jobs as it displaces. Great, I'll take that. However, how am I future-proofing myself in that, you know, I've been doing this for 15, 20 years. I'm not a 22-year-old. I'm not a millennial. I'm not a startup founder. What is there a sort of case for reskilling here?
I think it's about embracing and reskilling to a point. I think if you say no to technology and you don't embrace it, you're going to be left behind. I think that's quite clear.
So don't be resistant.
Exactly, don't be resistant, embrace it. And we've got to remember that a lot of the technologies that are around there are here to assist you in doing your job better. There are loads of things out there to upskill, to give people the confidence of learning what makes them different in the workplace. What's that added human value they can bring that can't be created or done via a machine or via AI?
What are some of the use cases that you've observed, just the application of AI, let's say, two different industries that are quite intriguing to you?
Yeah. So one of the really interesting ones I think that's just come to light is AI therapy, which is basically an online platform for the treatment of anxiety. And it takes you through a program based on your behavior and the answer to questions, and it helps and treats you through that program. The other areas that I think are really fascinating are in education. There have been some tests done with using AI robotics and robots actually within the classroom to help autistic children.
And I suppose as we see more of these use cases, you know, really tangible outcomes from the application of AI, almost balancing profit with purpose. So you have, yes, the part that impacts your bottom line, but actually there's the use of AI as well to create more meaningful, sustainable impact. Hopefully it'll start to feel like something that people want to really get under the hood of. Vic, thank you so much for being in our hot seat.
Thank you, Shivvy. Lovely to meet you.
Ditto. And thank you for watching.